Beckham for me.
Beckham?
Yeah.
Was the most surprising?
Yeah, I think it was too early.
Really?
Yeah.
115 caps he got, David Beckham. You still think he was...
Yeah, I mean, I'm probably the oldest person in here, and that, way, way back, it was so hard to get England caps, and now there's so many games a season. I didn't think 115 was too many.
Really?
Yeah, I still think he had something to give.
How many more caps do you think he could have got?
He had a couple of more years in him, I think.
A couple more years,
yeah.
Really? What do you think on that? Did David Beckham have a couple more years for England in him? Let us know. Tweet out FanTV UK. Dan, what's your answer, brother?
Yeah, I mean, Rooney's isn't too shocking. He's not been axed yet, to be honest. He's probably back. Beckham, for me, I have to agree, because I think the Beckham thing was a very sort of political thing.
Yeah.
Steve McLaren just came into the England job and he kind of wanted to show he was a little bit big, didn't he? I think it was one of those showing courage to drop a big player. It was just a little bit silly, wasn't it, at the end of the day? England lacked a lot of experience when they got thrown out of the Euro qualifications.
Yeah. What do you think, going back to that time, do you think anyone other than McLaren probably would have kept him in the squad?
Yeah, for sure. He was still performing, wasn't he?
I think so, definitely. McLaren was always a strange choice for me.
Yeah.
I've got to be honest. I don't know who I would have had, but McLaren was a strange choice, and I mean, I agree. I think he wanted to make a big statement,
We've got Southgate, of course, who's in charge for the next three games now, at least. We're playing tonight, of course, Slovenia. He's made a big decision. He's dropped Rooney. What are your thoughts on that, Mark?
I quite like Gareth Southgate. I actually think he's a good choice. Last time I was on the show, we talked about the fact that I said you needed a different manager for each tier in the Football League going up, but I also think you need a different manager, a different type of manager for internationals. And I think despite the 3 years at Middlesbrough, which we'll forget, Gareth Southgate's been brought up through tournament football with England.
Yeah.
And he's definitely an international type coach, manager, whatever. I think he'll do quite well.
Sean, one of our brilliant researchers on FanTV, you're right, brother. He was at the England game. He said not only Rooney was obviously getting booed by a section of fans, but the whole team were getting booed. What do you think of that, Dan?
Yeah, I watched the Malta game. I was actually Skyping in during it, and I kind of questioned why FanTV had me watching the game. It was absolutely awful.
Was it?
Oh, no, it was. I think the problem was with England in that game, and hopefully Southgate sorts it out, and we'll see that with Slovenia. There was a lot of times where the players just weren't moving. It was very sort of stationary, wasn't it? It wasn't just Rooney who wasn't putting in the effort. Now, Rooney was playing in central midfield. He's not a defensive midfielder. He's not a holding midfielder, right? But it wasn't just him who wasn't kind of putting any effort in. There was a lot of England players walking around very much behind the, or if you want to say, sorry, in front of the Malta defence. So yeah. There wasn't any runs happening. So I think the fans in general would have been unhappy with that because it should have been a thrashing. It should have been 5 or 6 nil.
Yeah, but is there any? Now, nowadays, it doesn't matter. You're in a tournament, it's the result. I honestly think it's the result. And you've got, England fans have got to make their mind up whether they actually want to win or entertain.
Yeah.
And there is a fine sort of difference between the two.
Well, we're not entertaining them, are we?
That's what I'm saying. But you're getting the results. And when you look back, some of the teams that have won, you go back to Germany, you go back to Italy and all that, some of their games were awful. But they won tournaments.
So you don't think we can gauge anything from number of goals scored, a 2-0 win is a 2-0 win? It doesn't matter.
I don't think so.
No. I totally disagree.
We'll choose to disagree.
The thing is, for me, right, you look at England, then you look at Portugal. Portugal obviously won the Euros, right? Portugal, in comparison to England, thrashed both of their opponents over the weekend, right? Ronaldo coming in and scoring 4 goals against Andorra. For me, that shows desire. And that's what you need in international tournaments. You need the players really putting in the effort and saying, you know what, we want to score as many goals as we can. We want to put the effort in and really kind of show that national pride on the pitch. And you look at the comparison, England kind of sauntered towards a 2-0 victory over Malta, could have done a little bit more. Portugal, for me, on the weekend, however, you look at them in comparison, left it all out on the pitch right there. And I think there's a major difference there, and that's why we don't succeed.
In the last tournament, though, what were they doing in the early rounds?
Portugal?
Yeah.
I mean, they made it through, though, didn't they?